Good afternoon, friends. I think you will be surprised to know there are two types of milk. There is A1 milk, which is produced out of Jersey, Holstein, and there is a Indian version of the cow, which is the Desi cow, which has a hump on its back. And that cow is the source of the A2 milk. And this A2 milk is the milk which the rishis, the munis, the saints, and the greatest people of mankind ever have taken it so that their brain gets nourished and so many wonderful things happen in their life. So this A1 and A2 milk are a component of two different varieties of cows. And there is a huge catastrophe in India because of the cow slaughter and because of the so many ill effects of vanishing of the A2 milk, vanishing of the Indian bred cow, which is there in India, has completely vanished. And the milk that we are getting today in our houses, which we may name at any name, Amul, maybe Gokul, maybe Mahananda, or any milk, they are all a variety of A1 milk, which is a toxic milk. I am a cardiologist, I am practicing in Mumbai, and it makes me responsible to tell all these wonderful people watching this video to tell about what this milk is and how toxic it is for this particular human race. And it is very rightly labeled as white poison in the European countries. And still in India, there are great people importing Indian cows from India and getting them to rear in New Zealand, in Australia, in Brazil. But in India, we have not got any awareness of this wonderful A2 milk which is there. I would really like to ask if anybody knows, and I would like to just give you some details of it. I start right now. The nutritious A2 milk of Vedic cows with hump versus the milk of humpless Western cows. So A1 milk is toxic casein protein, beta cosomorphin 7, harmful peptide B7, BCM7 of A1 milk, Surya Ketu Nadi of Vedic cow, fragrant smelling Indian humped cow with sebum glands. A2 milk produced by humped Indian cow is good for health, while A1 milk produced by the humpless Western cow is toxic for health. An Englishman, when I was traveling, he asked that what is the best cow, which is the best milk available. And he shot up an argument saying that the Indian cow gives very less milk, whereas the A1 milk is in abundance. So I laughed at him and said that it is not a matter of the daily consumption of milk that you calculate, but it is the yearly consumption that we really have to look at. And an Indian cow milks 3 times a year, whereas a Western cow milks only once a year. So if you calculate on an average, the A2 milk will always be in abundance because of the production of it 3 times in a year. This is a question of perception and simple maths, unfortunately, which the Indian people are not aware of. The Agnihotra ghee, that is whenever we perform the Agnihotra sacrifice, it is always the A2 ghee that is put up and that is used. The A1 ghee is considered as toxic, actually. Our ancient scriptures written by seers state that the humped Indian cow has a unique Surya Ketu Nadi on her back. Aapne dekha hoga ki ek hump jo hota hai cow ke upar, wahan par Surya Ketu Nadi hoti hai jo surya ki kirno ko apne andar simit karti hai. Isiliye the cow milk, if you ever have a look at that, it is yellow in color. It is that's why, because of the content of the Surya, the greatness of the Surya rays which it accumulates by the Surya Ketu Nadi. And we drink that beautiful milk which nourishes our whole body. Like a mother, she nourishes us. Similarly, the gomutra of urine of a cow has good effect only if the urine is from a humped cow. The urine produced by a humpless cow is toxic. So, gomutra drinking cow's urine as an elixir, vadakayal. The various problems associated with humpless cow's toxic A1 milk are, I am just citing them one by one. Autism, behraona, diabetes type 1, sudden death syndrome in infants, ulcerative colitis, cardiac problems, multiple sclerosis, mental disorders, Parkinson's, schizophrenia, obesity, arteriosclerosis, intolerance, bloating. Autistic and schizophrenic persons typically excrete large quantities of BCM7 in their urine. Man can live on A2 milk of the humped Indian cow alone. The West is now secretly engaged in smuggling our desi cows' embryos from India. The West has found out several decades ago that the A2 milk of Indian humped cows is more beneficial, as it has micronutrients like cytokines and minerals which enhance the immune system, A2 beta casein protein. So there are now the single agenda of the West of converting their useless A1 cows into A2 cows. They come to India for embryos of the Punganaur cows and the Vechur cows, as a result of which these cows is now almost an extinct. The ghee of Vechur cows was used in Ayurveda to produce medicines and lechems. Even today there is no mechanism to check illegal export of embryos at seaports in refrigerated containers.